In this video tutorial, we're going to see how to create a handwriting effect that can be used in presentations, blogs, or as a Google Classroom header. First of all, we go to PowerPoint and open a new slide and remove the text boxes. Then we go and insert an online image and search for a colored pencil. In this case, I'll choose a blue one, but you can choose any other color that you like. Then flip horizontally. Now we're going to remove that shadow. So we export the slide as an image. Then we choose PNG format. After that, we go to remove BG and remove the background. With the background, also the shadow will disappear. Now that we have saved, we will insert the new blue pencil without any shadow. Then we resize it and position it on the side above our text. We increase the size of the text. I have used Word Art Text to have this big, bold, and blue font. Once we are happy with the size, we go to Insert Image from our computer and then insert a Bitmoji that we have previously prepared and saved. We click on the Bitmoji and then go to Arrange and then flip horizontally. Now we resize the image and then align it with the text. You can also use the up and down arrows to move it carefully. To have this Bitmoji with a blue pencil, I just removed the original pencil by erasing it. I used Remove BG Eraser tool and then erased it carefully. Once I have erased it all, I saved it. After that, with a new slide, I uploaded both the Bitmoji and the blue pencil. First, you get the pencil and then the Bitmoji. Resize the pencil and then rotate and adjust the size with the help of the arrows. You can move it up and right click so that you can send it backward. Here we have our Bitmoji with the pencil we chose. I then grouped it with the Ctrl G and then paste it there. Now we are going to select the text and then insert an animation, a fade animation, and then we are going to choose an option which allows us to have it by letter and not the whole paragraph. So we choose by letter and then OK. Here we have the effect is fade and it enters by the letter. Now we are going to insert an animation for the pencil, so we choose that path, the personalized path for the pencil. So we draw a handwriting effect on top of what we have written. In this case, welcome. We just keep on writing and tracing. Once we have traced the final S, we double click so that it ends. And then here we have the effect. This is too fast, so we are going to multiply 0.5 into how many letters that we have. So we count, this is should be 18. And then we're going to do this quick calculations of having 18 times 0.5, and that is 9 seconds. So we go back to our slide and put the duration 9 seconds because every letter will enter 0.5. So we will make it last for 9 seconds, and we will make sure that the text will have a duration of 0.5. Now we go to animation options and then we put 0. We bring that smooth end and smooth start to 0, and then we press OK. Here we can see that it's quite smooth, the writing, but still is behind the text. So we will need to adjust that. But before we do that, we click on that animation button and then pull the pencil that we can see. That's where it will start the writing. So we need to position it right at the beginning of our text. So let's say into that position, and then we pull a little bit down near the S letter, and then we click again if you want to position it and adjust the size properly. Now that we have done that, we go to the animation exit, so that when it finishes the writing, it will disappear. So we choose an animation that makes the pencil disappear from bottom or to the left as we want. And then finally, we select the Bitmoji and we put another animation that we like. We have plenty to choose from. So we choose one that bounces from top in this case. Once we have chosen our animation, we click on that panel so that we can choose the entrance sequence, so the build order. So at the beginning we have with a click, and then we can choose the text to let's move that in so that we can see it. So the text will enter with the previous, so that the pencil and the text start simultaneously. The Bitmoji will enter after the previous, so we adjust the entrances and the exits from there. So make sure the animation is on click with the writing pencil. And then we have the text which enters with the previous. And finally, we have again the writing pencil which exits after the previous. And then we have our Bitmoji enter. And here we have our final result. From the animation panel, you can change the names of the three elements that you're working on, so that you can recognize which one is which when you put the animation order. Otherwise, it is quite confusing which one is the image that you want it to enter first and which one you want it to enter last. So from there, you can recognize which one you are trying to give the order of animation. So on the click, and the second one is with the previous. And then we have after the previous, and finally the last entrance of the Bitmoji, which is after the last animation. Make sure to arrange the pencil in front of the text, otherwise you will see that it writes behind the text, which is not good and realistic. The size of the slide is widescreen, and we use this size to export it as a GIF. So we go to File, Export, and we will save not as a PNG, but we go to Create a GIF. And then we go to easygif.com. We upload our GIF that we created with PowerPoint. We need easygif.com to set the loop selection. Otherwise, it just goes on, and that's quite annoying. So we go to the loop count, and then we choose just number one. In this way, it will stop once the writing is completed. So we make a GIF, and here we have the same GIF that we have created, but with the difference that now it stops completely once the writing is over. Now we save it, and we can use everywhere that we want. For example, We can use it in our classroom header. We upload and then resize. Once we resized, here is the final result. It goes just one loop, and if you refresh the page, it starts again, but it stops once it finishes writing. Otherwise, it is quite distracting. That's how I like. Not only in our Google Classroom header that we can use it, but we can also insert it in our Google Sites header or in PowerPoint or Google Slides presentations in order to draw the attention. In the coming videos, we are going to see more attention catching strategies like this, so don't miss out and subscribe. That's all for now, and I'll see you next week. Bye!